What is up, YouTube, man? Today, we're talking about Chase Down Artist on NBA 2K22 and how great of a badge it is. If you guys are new, if you want to drop me a like and subscribe, of course, I would appreciate it a ton. For this video, I'm playing the matchmaking on NBA 2K22 next gen, and if you guys haven't tried it out, I would definitely recommend it. It's a ton of fun. But you guys may be wondering, is Chase Down Artist good on current gen or next gen or both? And let me go ahead and tell you guys, it's amazing on both games. The gameplay you're seeing in this video, it's on next gen, but if you guys want me to make a video similar to this on current gen, I definitely can. Just let me know in the comments if you guys want that. But I'm lucky enough to be able to get the badge at every single level. I can get it on bronze, silver, gold, and Hall of Fame on my build. The clips, I was using it on all different levels. And in this gameplay right here, when you see me get the chase downs, when you see it pop up, I'm using it on gold. Now you guys may be wondering, what is the best level to run Chase Down Artist? And I'm gonna go in and tell you guys, the highest level you can get the badge on your build, that is what I would recommend. Put it on. It works at bronze, it works at silver, it works at gold, and it works at Hall of Fame. Look at this. This guy, he breaks my ankles right there. I'm still able to recover and I get a chase down block. You guys will see it pop up, but it's gonna be delayed. I mean, you see Green Machine, all these badges are still popping up. It's so delayed. I don't know why they have to show me every single badge. It takes forever. You see, it tells me I get a defensive rebound, but you're gonna see chase down gold pop up. But like I was saying, no matter what level you get this badge on, it's definitely worth maxing out. If your build only gets it on bronze, definitely throw it on bronze. Chase downs work this year. They were not that good of a badge on NBA 2K21 next gen because people would get contact dunks. There was not really anything you could do once somebody ran past you and gotten a dunk animation. You see Chase Down Artist Gold finally popping up. But this year, that is different. If somebody gets past you, you can definitely, I mean, look at this. He keeps breaking my ankles and I keep getting the block. Now, he is going up with weak layup, so it, maybe if he was going for a dunk, he would have a better chance. But I'm not going to lie. You guys even saw in some of the clips, even when people are going for dunks, I still get the chase down block. There is just no safe way to take a dunk this year. I mean, I have seen it all. I have seen people run to the paint, stop, run back out to the three-point line. I've even seen people run to the paint, stop, pump fake once, and then go up. I mean, they are just so afraid to get blocked, and I'm glad 2K has adjusted blocking. Now, is it a little bit OP? Yes, I mean, there definitely is times where I'm like, wow, I got that block. I mean, my player really leaps for it. But at the same time, it's kind of tough to gut block. I mean, you're not seeing a lot of these smaller point guards putting block on their build. A lot of people are ignoring defensive stats. Me, I am somebody that loves to play defense. So no matter what build I make, I'm definitely going to want to have block on. And if you can get the block on your build, I would definitely recommend going for it. Now, not everybody has a build where it makes sense. I mean, there are advantages to making a 5'9" point guard for offense, you know, playing threes, playing the stage, playing pro-am. Now, you're not gonna get chase downs on that build, so of course you're not gonna want to do it. But if you're a big, maybe you're even a 7'3" center and you don't know about putting chase down artists on because, you know, you're kind of slow, if they get to the paint, how often is it gonna work? Trust me, guys, definitely put this badge on. No matter what your build is, no matter how you play, it doesn't matter if you're playing 5v5 rec, it doesn't matter if you're playing the ones court, put this badge on and play for chase downs. Once somebody beats you to the paint, it is not over. You can recover. I mean, you saw in this video, if I can get my ankles broken twice and I can get chase downs out of both of those instances, it definitely is an overpowered badge. Let me know what you guys think of it. This is Tonic. I'll catch you guys in the next one. I'm out. Peace.